Hey, Vsauce, Chris here. When was the last time you got sick with strep throat? Or maybe just about any other disease for that matter. And when you took antibiotics for them, you surely did read the instructions on the label, correct? If you didn't, then let me explain to you why that might not have been a good idea. This is genetic variation. Now, genetic variation all has to do with mutations. So, basically, mutations are just an alteration to your DNA sequence. Now, let's say your CO changed to a CX. Now, that's a mutation and you just got AIDS. So, how does this relate to antibiotic resistance anyways? Well, just like any other organism, individual bacteria can go through random mutations at any point in time. Now, don't worry just yet, but some of these mutations may be harmful. But every now and then, one of these mutations come along and it gives the organism a boost in survival, making it resistant to certain antibiotic. As the non-resistant bacteria are killed off, there is more room and resources for the resistant ones to thrive. Now this is overreproduction. Now, these bacteria reproduce asexually. That means its offspring arise from a single organism and inherit the genes from that pair only. How does this correlate with antibiotic resistance? Well, first off, these bacteria mostly die off due to the antibiotics, but because it was used more and more frequently, they caused more bacteria to become resilient, which then led to a larger population. This is selective pressure. Selective pressure is any phenomenon which alter the behavior of living organisms within a given environment. It is a driving force of evolution and natural selection. This can easily play in the evolution of bacteria, because I just told you about 30 seconds ago that when antibiotics are being injected more and more times into your body, the bacteria became more resistant after experiencing more times. And finally, fitness. Fitness is concerned more about the reproductive capability of an organism in its genetic contribution to the gene pool. As I said, these bacteria reproduce asexually. This plays a role in evolution because as one bacteria might pass, they drop their DNA, leaving their resistant data for the other bacteria. Now take a look at this graph. On point A in 1928, Sir Alexander Fleming observed that the mold Penicillium kills the bacterium Staphylococcus. When you take a look at the graph, it appears nothing is happening at that time. However, on point B, in 1939, researchers at the Oxford University isolated the antibiotic penicillin from the mold Penicillium. Now the year is 1941, and a large-scale production of the penicillin antibiotic begins. It's now 1945, and there is a boom in bacterial strains. This is due to the fact that the more penicillin that is being used, the more resistant of the bacteria can become. So how does evolution play a part in this? Well, you can see from the graph, and the scenarios on page 140, that in 1925, antibiotics were not yet created. When that girl had that high of a fever, there was no way that she could have survived. In 1945, 20 years later, the girl was given penicillin, and it was being distributed by doctors everywhere, and she was cured within 24 hours. However, the girl in 1965 overused the penicillin. She seemed fine afterward, but then died 2 years later of a high fever. This is the evolution from how people have corrected, used, and then going too far and overusing the drug. So, please, just be careful and take care of yourselves. Life is beautiful.